Oh, okay, I'm sorry. See, what happens is in Isaiah, God says to his people. In Isaiah, God's talking to his people. And in Amos, God is talking to his people. And in Jeremiah, God is talking to his people. And all of it's the same thing. He's talking to Israel and Judah. And what he's saying to them is, though your prayers be many, I will not hear them. I will not answer them. Put down your instruments, your friendship offerings, your offerings. I do not want them. You know, I hate your worship. I hate your worship. Why is God saying that to his people? He's saying it because in all three of those circumstances, child sacrifice was going on. And it wasn't being opposed by God's people, who are supposed to bring justice to the land, who are supposed to defend the innocent, who are supposed to like hold back those that are being led to slaughter. But instead of that, what are we doing? We're going to sing events. Where down the street, there's an abortion clinic that murders kids and nobody cares. And what they do is they're part of the pro-life movement where they regulate how, when, and where they can murder kids. We shouldn't regulate how we can kill kids. We need to make it illegal. We need to, like, be obedient to the word of God. We haven't failed to be pro-life. We failed to be Christian. When we love God, we love what God loves. Yeah, that's why we're not trying to talk to unbelievers. Them, we'd give them the gospel, yeah. Right? But for us, we're the people of God. And what does God say in his word to his people that care more about worship, yeah, than about justice? You know, because we have to line our worship up with how God wants to be worshiped.
Yes.
And how does God want to be worshiped? He says, put down your instruments. First, bring justice to the land. And then come worship me. And you know what he'll do? He'll answer our prayers. We have a God, you know, like he actually wants us to be obedient to him, and he'll help us, right? So we're not here because we're mad at anybody. You know, we don't hate the church. We don't. We're part of the church, right? We just read Isaiah and understand that it's about us, and Jeremiah, and it's about us. It's about God's heart towards the orphans. Do you ever hear the story about the how God says don't move the cornerstone from the orphan?
Yeah.
So like the parent dies, right? And there's an orphan. And the land, they mark the land stones on the property, right?
Yes.
That's how they did it in Israel, right? So what would happen is when an orphan, when somebody would be orphaned, there would be no advocate for that orphan. So the property owners next to them would move the stones over, so now they had more property. And the orphan had no recourse, right? And God says he hates that. And what we've done is we stood by while they moved the cornerstone on children to where it was illegal and it was murder to have an abortion to now you can do it at up to 21 weeks. We moved the cornerstone up on those children. And the church is silent. Like, a lot of them have a good moral opinion. It's wrong. But having a good moral opinion and not taking action makes us more guilty to know the word of God and ignore what God tells us to do.
We are from Brazil, and we are fighting that in Brazil.
What's that?
We are from Brazil.
Oh, you're from Brazil.
We are fighting that against the government there because they want to legalize that.
Right.
But brother, good job.
Thank you. Hey, God bless you guys. Welcome to America. Don't take home America Christianity.
Yeah.
Follow the word of God. Do what it says. God bless you guys.